Merren, Lynx Air, Canada's newest ultra-low-cost carrier, set to start flying in 2022. We are still dealing with a pandemic, still dealing with travel restrictions and guidelines. I'm just curious about the timing of this. Is this the right time for a new airline?
Absolutely, Larysa. I do believe it is. We have a vision to offer ultra low fares to travellers in Canada to enable them to fly more often than they currently can. And I think that Canadians right now are yearning to travel more. And so we plan to open the skies to more Canadians with ultra low fares and make it accessible to everybody. The pandemic, you're right, is absolutely not over. And it's going to be interesting as Canada opens up more and the rest of the world opens up more. I'm sure there'll be setbacks and there'll be some hiccups along the way. We just need to be very nimble. But as I said, for leisure travel and visiting friends and family type of travel, we're the airline for them because we'll be offering them affordable fares and making it easier for them to travel. And I think people are yearning to do just that.
Lynx Air, not a new company. It's been rebranded a few times over the years. What went wrong? Why couldn't they get off the ground?
Oh, nothing went wrong. It's an airline that has an interesting history. It's done a number of different, picked up a number of different opportunities. But right now, we, as of yesterday, we renamed ourselves Lynx Air. And that's to align with our new business model. We're taking up a new opportunity here in Canada now. We believe airfares have been too high in Canada for too long. And there's an opportunity for us to come in with our business model, which is based on the ultra low cost carrier model that's been very successful in the United States and Europe, to open the skies to more people to travel, to make travel accessible to everybody. We believe that there are a lot of people who either can't travel or can't travel as much as they would like, and they're our target audience.
What are you going to bring from your previous life at Virgin Australia? What were some of the lessons learned there?
Well, I've got lots of experience across lots of different areas at Virgin Australia. So most recently, my role was as CEO of the ultra low cost carrier Tiger Air, which was a subsidiary of Virgin Australia. So Australia is a country which has got, you know, vast distances and a dispersed population just like Canada. So there's a lot of similarities. Even the competitive dynamics are very similar here in Canada to Australia. So I'll bring a lot of that expertise. But at Virgin, I also was the CEO of the regional airline. I also did a startup, started up a cargo business from scratch. So I'm bringing all that experience to this role, but I'm surrounded by some great Canadian aviation, experienced aviation professionals who are helping me to readjust my thinking to what the nuances are of the Canadian landscape, because there are lots of differences as well as similarities. Particularly Canada is very, very long. I think it's probably twice the width of the Australian continent. And interestingly enough, that does make the airline economics quite different. But I've got a great team around me who are supporting me with that.
You have brought up some very interesting points with respect to Canada's population and Canada's geography. This is also a very saturated market in Canada. We have a Flair Air, a Swoop. How do you stand out in a saturated market?
Well, we don't believe it's saturated. We wouldn't be launching if we did. We do believe there's pent-up demand. As you see in Europe and in the United States, with the true ultra-low-cost model and enough of it, it actually stimulates more demand. So we're not here to take market share from our competitors. We're actually here to inspire more Canadians to travel, and that's the market that we're going to be targeting. So we actually believe there is more opportunity for the Canadian travel market to grow, and we will grow with that.
Now, we haven't seen routes or schedules or pricing for that matter. Where are you going to start?
I can't tell you that just yet. That's still a secret. We're still talking to airports across the country. We will be starting with domestic short haul and long haul flying. I think that's where the biggest opportunity is. I think people will still be over the next 12 months wanting to fly domestically. And with the changing regulations internationally, in any event, there's too much uncertainty really from our perspective. But evolving through next year, we'll start to fly into the United States and ultimately internationally.
You have an order in for Boeing's newest, I guess, 737 aircraft. There's also an order in, correct me if I'm mistaken here, for the next 7 years for 46 aircraft.
That's the same order. Yes, it's one order for 46 Boeing 737 aircraft that we announced yesterday, three of which will be arriving in the first quarter of 2022. It has 189 seats. It's a single class cabin, classic low-cost carrier cabin, although nowadays with the seats, slimline seats, not jammed in as a lot of Canadians would probably expect from an ultra-low-cost carrier, it's actually relatively roomy. Some of our seat pitch is similar to WestJet and Air Canada's seat pitch.
What makes a bare-bones model attractive?
Absolutely, it's the price that attracts people to you, but we, I guess, want to also focus on the customer service. We would like to redefine what Canadians' perception is of the ultra-low-cost carrier. I think one of the reasons why it hasn't been well adopted in Canada to date is because there is a perception that low-cost means low service, and we don't agree with that. We believe that you can offer low fares and high quality. We'll be flying brand new aircraft, so the actual experience, physical experience in the plane will be great. And it doesn't cost anything to provide great customer service. It's just really about building a really strong customer-focused culture, which we've already started to do, and that will provide great customer service. So people can expect a great experience with us as well as low fares.
When can we expect to see your routes or pricing?
Over the next few weeks, we're still finalizing our booking engine, and that will be going live in a few weeks' time. And that's when we'll be announcing our destinations, and you'll also see our pricing.
In a time of inflation and rising oil prices, gas prices, how do you fit in to this equation?
Yes, well, fuel price is always a challenge for all airlines. And one of the advantages that we'll have is with the latest generation Boeing 737 aircraft that we'll be bringing in, they have leading edge fuel efficiency. So that will actually help to reduce our costs in a rising fuel environment, as well as actually contributing to a sustainable future. So it's something that we always have to deal with. Costs are something that you need to manage, and it's about being very, very efficient in utilizing your aircraft.